Have you been wanting to make your own quiz app but don't have any coding knowledge whatsoever? Let me show you how simple it can be with Jotform apps. Hey everyone, welcome to Jotform. I'm Kimberly. Now, if you already have forms made up with really awesome quizzes, this is a really great way to put all those quizzes in one place with an app. So if you do already have a form that has a quiz in it, you'll find that form. Then over on the right-hand side, we have more. Then you can choose create an app. If you have multiple quizzes, which we'll show you in just a second, you can choose multiples and then create a new app. But let's say maybe I want to start from scratch, or I kind of want to see what other people have done. Well, let me show you how. Up in the top, we're going to choose My Forms and then My Apps. Then again, up in the top left, the purple Create App button. And then here's where we can start from scratch, or we can use a template. So for this, to get those creative juices flowing, I'm going to go ahead and choose Use a Template. From here, we have three different ways. We can either scroll and see if something catches our eye. We can physically search for the word quiz up in the top, or over on the left-hand side under categories, we can see if anything there jumps out to us. So I'm going to go ahead and search for quiz. As of right now, we have one template. So let's take a look at what this looks like. I'm going to go ahead and click on the green button in the top right that says use template. Okay, so before we dive into how to make this, kind of want to give it a scroll and see what this template looks like. So we can see that we have an icon, we have a header, text, and then we have these buttons right here. It looks like these are all the quizzes that this template offers. So we have a Friends quiz, Disney, Joker, and then Rick and Morty. Now, if you look down in the bottom left of the screen, you can see we have different pages. So we have a Friends quiz, Disney, Joker, and Rick and Morty. Now, if we take a little scroll, we can see add a new page. So that means whenever we're looking at our app, our users are not going to see this unless they click on the Friends quiz. So each one of these is a new page. So we have the Friends, so we have a new page, Disney, new page, Joker, new page, Rick and Morty. So back up to the top, we can see that these buttons, and buttons to me are one of the most diverse aspects of this app. So if we click on the Friends quiz, we can look at the settings over on the right, and we can see a button can take people to a URL, they can send an email, a phone call, open a form, or they can navigate to a page. So that is what these buttons are doing. So they're having you go to a different page to view this quiz. So we can see the Friends quiz, navigate to a page. Right here, we can choose which page it goes to. This one is going to Friends. So let's go to these second pages. Let's scroll down. So we can see this Friends one. If we click on it, we can see that it is a form. So if I click on edit form, it's going to take me to literally edit this form. And we can see up here at the top, this is a clone of Friends Trivia. So that means that this form is now in my Jotform. Okay, let's go back. If we keep scrolling down, we can see we have go to homepage. So this is another button that is going to take them to a page. That very first page. So let me show you how to add in each one of these. If you are familiar with Jotform, you've used Jotform before, this is going to feel very familiar. On the left-hand side, we have add element and we have our basic elements. So if we came in the way that we did and we didn't choose a form, we can choose a form here. We can search through all of the forms that we have. We can choose the ones we want and then click on add forms and it'll populate in our app. We have a heading, we have a paragraph, we have link. If you want to utilize a document like upload a PDF, you can do that. You can add in an image. You can utilize that button feature. We have image gallery, image slider, a video. If you want to add in a map, you can. If you want people to follow you on social media, you can do the social follow and even testimonials. And if you have data elements, we have that as well as page elements. Now up at the top, we also have widgets. So these are kind of more dynamic pieces. So just for example, if you're on Facebook or on Instagram, you can link those, or maybe you utilize WhatsApp, you can utilize that. But going back over to basic, it's very, very simple. One of my favorite ways to add in an element is just to click and drag. You put it exactly where you want it to be. And then from here, the settings, we can edit what it says, what it does, and even what it looks like. All right, so let's say that we want to change this background image. We want it to look like something different, more like us. Up in the top right, we have the app designer. It looks like a paint roller. Go ahead and choose that. We can change the overall color scheme. If we don't want an image, we just want a background color, we can choose two different colors to kind of create this ombre effect. Or if we have an image we want to use, we can use remove image and upload our own. And we can even change the font family. Now, something else that's really neat is if you go to app layouts, if you have multiple buttons and maybe some are on the left, maybe some are on the right, and you want them all on the center, instead of choosing each button and changing where it is aligned, you can come to the app layouts and you can utilize the center aligned option, and it'll put all of your buttons, all of your elements in the center. So let's go up to settings and let's see what that has to offer real quick. So the first is the app status. It's automatically going to be enabled. If you'd like to disable it at some point or maybe on a specific date, you can do that here. We always are gonna have the continue forms later option on. We also have add to home screen modal. So that means whenever someone opens your app, it'll say, hey, do you want to add this quiz app to your home screen? And it really is a neat feature. And then if you'd like to turn on the progress bar, you can. Back on the left, we have the app name and icon. So if you want to change the name of your app, if you want to change the icon, we can do that right here under edit icon. For this, it looks like they utilized an image. So if you have a specific image you want to utilize, you can remove image and upload your own. If not, we have a ton of icons to choose from. Back on the left, the splash screen, if we want to change the color of the background and of the font, we can do that. But let's go up to publish and see how we can get our app in people's hands. First way is to copy the link. We can send it out or we can post it on social media. If we have someone specific we want to send it to, we can send it to them via email. If we are in person, we can use the download QR code option where people can scan it and open your app right there. But let's take a look what this app looks like on the desktop. I'm going to go ahead and click on open in a new tab. All right, so here's our app, and you can see that add to home screen modal. It says, hey, do you want to add this app to your home screen? Again, I think that's one of my favorite options with the apps. So if I get rid of that, we can see that we're on the home screen. We only have those first four buttons, and up in the top right, we have each individual page. And if you're on mobile, it's going to be on the top left. But let's say I want to do the friends quiz. I'm going to click on the friends quiz, and it's going to take us to that page. And you can see that there's nothing else. It's just the friends quiz and then to go back to the home page. Now, another really awesome thing about this is whenever you have a form included, it is in the app. They don't have to exit the app to use it. So we can see that this is the form. We can start it and it stays within the app. I think that is so amazing. Whoop, big fat goalie. I could be here all night doing this friends quiz. Okay, so we can see if we go to the Disney character quiz, same thing, it pops up within that nice little box and everything stays here within the app. They're not going to have to leave the app, it stays in here. So if you have any questions about creating your own no-code quiz app, please let us know and I'll see you next time.